This is NBC Nightly News, Thursday, May 4th, reported by John Chancellor.
Good evening. The United States broke off the Paris peace talks today. The Viet Cong proclaimed a government in the captured provincial capital of Quang Tri. Hubert Humphrey won the Ohio presidential primary, and J. Edgar Hoover was buried in Washington. We've got coverage on all of these stories, satellites from Paris, and we'll begin with the peace talks story. Today was the 149th session of the Paris talks, and nobody knows whether there'll be another. A revolutionary administration in the capital of Quang Tri province, the first capital they've captured in the whole war. There was not much serious fighting today, but the pressure on the city of Hue continued to build. Enemy units were moving toward Hue from three directions. South Vietnamese President Tu flew to Hue today to confer with the general charged with defending the city. The general earlier said said deserters would be shot on sight, and that seemed to sober up the drunken soldiers who had been looting and burning. The South Vietnamese made a counterattack today, the first counterattack they've made since the enemy offensive began 5 weeks ago. South Vietnamese paratroopers about 20 miles north of Pleiku engaged the enemy in an effort to clear a mountain pass along Highway 14, which has been cut by the enemy. And Jim Laurie tells us what it's like to be in Pleiku.
The central highland city of Pleiku is roughly 30 miles south of Con Tum along this road. The critical situation there has had a marked effect here. South Vietnamese 23rd Division troops, only 10 miles outside of Pleiku, are dismantling Firebase 42, a defense post along the road to Con Tum. Some of the troops are being moved up to fight in Con Tum, others move back. The people view such movements and the general situation with alarm. U.S. officials say roughly 20% of Pleiku residents have already left town. Most of them wealthier merchants who have closed their shops and food stalls. Many have chosen to leave by air because roads are insecure, but tickets are hard to come by. On the black market, air tickets to Saigon are selling for $40 apiece, five times the normal fare. The government is facilitating evacuation a little by issuing travel papers to all leaving, but transport is up to the individual. Most, of course, cannot afford the high cost of evacuation. Those such as the poor Montagnard tribesmen have resigned themselves to staying and continue as they always have. Rental of a truck out of town costs more than $500, and there's no guarantee these people will get out with their possessions because the enemy has ambushed civilians on the roads regularly for the last week. Other people in cities like Con Tum have had it much harder. 5,000 of them are now living in this primitive schoolyard refugee site. They got out late and could take little with them. Many more can't get out at all. The people of Pleiku have heard the stories of the people of Con Tum who tried to get out too late. They don't want to be trapped in the same way, so they are now leaving while the leaving is still good. Jim Laurie, NBC News, Pleiku, South Vietnam.
The United States today began resupplying the South Vietnamese with tanks to replace those lost in the recent fighting. M-48 tanks reconditioned in Japan were flown to the Da Nang Air Base and unloaded today. And the Defense Department said that more planes are being sent to the war zone. That will mean we have sent about 300 planes since the new enemy offensive began, bringing American air strength to 800 in that area. There was talk about the buildup this morning at the Pentagon news briefing. Robert Goralski covered that story.
The Pentagon volunteered information today on a further buildup of U.S. air and naval power in Southeast Asia. It announced that more ships and planes are on the way. At the same time, pictures were released showing how the Soviets have been aiding the North Vietnamese. The Soviet freighter was photographed on its way to Haiphong. It was carrying 16 trucks and crates on its deck, and the Pentagon said vessels of this kind generally carry sophisticated equipment below deck. The kinds of equipment were illustrated with these displays, Soviet weapons which have been used by the North Vietnamese for the first time since the offensive was launched, the T-54 medium tank, the ZSU mobile anti-aircraft vehicle, and 130-millimeter field guns. All this seemed to be setting the stage for heightened military action against North Vietnam, including more airstrikes against Hanoi and Haiphong. But the administration has also hinted at other options which have never been explained. Robert Goralski, NBC News at the Pentagon.
American casualties last week were two men killed in action and 24 wounded, but actually 15 Americans were killed in action last week, but only two deaths were tabulated in time for the official report. South Vietnamese casualties were 769 killed, 2,794 wounded.